Hey. Hello. Welcome to Piposaru 2001. So quick primer, I said some of this in the chat, but I'll say it with my voice as well. So this game was released between Ape Escape 1 and 2. Does not follow quite the usual gameplay formula, which you'll notice very quickly. It's basically like, I guess I don't know the whole story behind it, but it feels like it was a learning project for the team that makes Ape Escape. Like, they were figuring out how do we even make a PS2 game. They had some fun with it. Other stuff, I guess I can get rid of this. The cutscenes in the game don't work right. I'm running this from disk in an emulator. I actually bought a copy of it. And the emulator doesn't like to play the cutscenes. So I ripped them from the disk and we'll play them outside of the game. So first cutscene that we'll go for is the attract mode. So enjoy this. Alright, so there's the attract mode. Here's what you got to look forward to. Let me pull up next video. This next one is not going to be super useful to anyone, but I'm going to play it just for completion's sake. There's a second attract mode that recaps the storyline of the first game and gives a little bit of insight into what's going on in this game. It's all in Japanese with subtitles that are in Japanese also. So have fun with this.
ようこそ研究所に。みんな元気にしとったかの？初めて来た子もいるようじゃな。ゲームを始める前に前作のお話をしておくかの。事件の発端はわしの発明したピークポイントヘルメット、通称ピポヘルという、頭の良くなるヘルメットをモンキーパークにいるスペクターというボスザルがかぶってしまったことから始まるのじゃが、知恵のついたサルたちはスペクターの先頭でモンキーパークを脱走しよった。その後サルたちはこの研究所を襲い、開発中のタイムマシンを奪って過去の世界にタイムスリップしていってしまったのじゃ。そしてスペクターはとんでもないことを始めおった。
とにかく俺はこれからあらゆる時代に仲間や俺の作ったモンスターを送り込み、人間が支配してきた地球の歴史を全部書き換える。そして世界を征服するんだ。
しかし一緒に巻き込まれてタイムスリップしていたカケル君の活躍で大騒ぎになる前にスペクターたちを全員捕まえることができた。こうして猿たちはモンキーパークに戻り事なきを得たというわけじゃ。そして今回モンキーパークがリニューアルで一時閉鎖されることになっての、少しの間この研究所で猿たちを預かることになったのじゃ。もう少しで到着すると思うんじゃが、どうやってたくさんの猿の面倒を見るかって。実は 改良型のピポヘルをみんなに内緒で発明しておいたから大丈夫じゃよ。
誰か来たよ。
おー、到着したようじゃ。ではみんな、また後での。
Alright, so the basic build up for this game is that after the events of the first game, the Monkey Park has decided to have a renovation done, and they need some place to keep the monkeys. And so they're like, hey, like, that professor was holding on to a whole bunch of monkeys for a while. Maybe we should see if he'll babysit the apes for us. So the professor is happy to do so, and he has developed in secret a Peepo Helmet 2.0. So he's planning to use the second generation Peepo Helmet to keep the monkeys orderly while he takes care of them at his laboratory. And of course, the place that he plans to keep the apes at his lab is, you'll see in the next cutscene. But that's the gist of it. Let me put the next cutscene on. There's three of these, and then we'll be done. Is this the one? Yeah.
それに対策は考えてある。
ここってこの間完成したトレーニングルームね。そっか、バーチャルスペースに放し飼いにするのね。
そうじゃ、明暗じゃろう。ではそろそろ始めるぞ。
なんでピコヘグなんかかぶってるの。
こいつを完成とけばいる場所がわかるんじゃよ。監視はせんといかんがな。
あいつらを監視するのは俺がやってやるよ。
なんであんたがここにいるのよ。
そりゃボスだからな。
まったくもう、あんたらみんなと一緒に遊んできなさい。俺は任せたからおとなしくしてんのよ。
はい、研究所です。
モンキーパーク園長です。
これはこれは、
あの、先ほど言い忘れたんですが、衛生のために全てのパンツを選択してくださいね。嫌がるかもしれませんが、衛生のためです。
あー、すべてのパンツ一体何枚あるんじゃろ
う。一体誰が集めんのよ。
博士、こんにちは。サル来たんでしょ。
かけるくん、
あんたっていつもいいタイミングで現れるのね。
え、何。
実は頼みたいことがあっての。バーチャルスペースに行ってサルたちのパンツを集めてきてくれんかの。
いっぱいあるんでしょ。
大丈夫、今回もわしの発明品でバックアップするからの。よろしく頼むぞ。
Alright, so basically the professor's big plan is to upload all the apes into virtual space, which is where the training rooms and I think maybe the time station from the first game are located. It's also where Charu lives, the green girl from the loading screens and stuff. But anyway, so they get all the apes in there, and then the park manager calls, the monkey park manager, and is like, oh, hey, by the way, while you got those apes, can you clean all their pants for us? Thank you. She makes sure to stress that it's for hygiene. It's very important. And so the professor and Natsumi are like, who's going to do it? And then, of course, Spike just trundles into the door and... he's the perfect one for the job. So that's the story of this game, as far as I can tell. And now, just in time, boop! Here's the actual video game. Alright, so with all that out of the way, it's time to play Piposaru 2001. Whoops, that's the cutscene that doesn't work. We'll skip that. So this is just like a little warning about yellow pants monkeys, the basic kind. It tells you that they have been made smarter by the Peepo Helmet. and they love bananas. Here we are in Yoshi's Story. I'm not gonna do translation of these. I'll tell you when there's important stuff, but this is basically just a explanation of the controls and what you're supposed to be doing. Which is vacuuming pants from monkeys. Frickin' see ya. So there's a few ways to do this. You gotta vacuum. The right stick is not used at all in this game, which is very strange, but it wouldn't really work with the right stick, I think. You hold down the square button, and you can aim in a circle, and if apes get caught in your vacuum, they start to try and run away. And because you're inhaling them with the vacuum, they can't get away. But when you let go of them, and take their pants, they go flying in that direction. So you can use them to knock out other monkeys, take their pants. You can also do this spin attack thing. Just like mash the square button a few times, and also if you bump monkeys that you have like currently absorbed into other monkeys, they'll fall over with a melee attack. Once you've got enough pants, all the pants, you can toss them in this washing machine for hygiene. And then at the end of the level, you get a ranking, which the first one is your time rank, the second one is your... wait. That's also... I don't know. Third one, though, is for getting all the pants at once. I don't think I've ever not gotten that second one before, so I don't really know what it's for. I played through one world of this by accident. And then I peeked into the other worlds also. Because it's really fun. It's very simple. Yeah, no time is what I read too, but like, that doesn't make any sense. Oh, it might be, maybe it's if you don't pick up, there are some little time booster items. Maybe if you don't use those? It's a mystery. This game has a world map. Stages are laid out in an interesting way. So if I go to... this one. This menu, it shows like a different routes I can take. When I played the first time, I think I took the top route. But like, I'm not really sure if the routes matter, or if these are like the only way that you can get to certain stages. So like, if I wanted to go through this bottom route, I would also have to start back at level 1. I'm unsure. But I'll follow the path that I followed the first time. Also, it's fun to note, I'm pretty sure, I'm like 99% sure, that they did not update the model between this and Ape Escape 1 for the apes. Like, it looks like the same model, it just has shaders on it now instead of nothing. So this stage introduces two things. There's a pants capsule in the center here, which has Spectre's face on it. I assume that Spectre has invented this to make my life harder. The other thing that introduces are these bomb discs, which are they're called mecha discs. There's different kinds of them. This one is a bomb, and what this does is if you get near some apes, toss it down, blow them up. Pants go flying off. Oh, frick. Ah, no! Yeah, that's something the apes can do. They can yank on your pants chain that you got, and they can undo it. So you want to put all the pants in the machine at once for, you know, maximum score, but it can be difficult because the more pants you have, the more vulnerable you are. Pop them in. Yoshi's Story style, there are pants surrounding the screen that tell you how many pairs you have and how many remain. And when they're sparkling, that's when you know you've got enough. Also, I forgot to mention this before, but when you're sucking in an ape, I can't think of a good verb for that. When you got an ape in your grasp, you can aim them a little bit vertically as well, which I didn't know the first time I was playing this. And that's going to come in handy in a little bit here. Also, the number of apes and the number of pants like really skyrockets real fast. Gets pretty tricky. Okay, yeah, this stage has another new thing. It's our buddy. Spectre's here. So Spectre in this game, as far as I can tell, despite what the Wikipedia article has to say, has nothing to do with the fact that the monkey's pants are dirty. However, he's just like here to constantly get in your way during the course of the game. So, whoops! Oh no! Oh, that's fine. Won't get maximum range. But, so what he does here is, if you have pants trailing behind you, he will beam them back up in his UFO, and he'll also beam monkeys up from the abyss when you toss them in. And, if you're a good shot, if not, hit him. Some of these guys. And he drops a bunch of life pieces. Spike's life bar, I don't really know the way it works in this, to be honest. It's sectioned into three parts up there. Like when you get hit, you lose a full section of it. But one little life pickup does not fill up the section. I think it takes like multiple pieces to fill up a section. Yeah. Also, you cannot like destroy Spectre, just in general, but also in this game. No matter how many times you knock monkeys into him, he'll just keep dropping multiple pieces and continue on his way. But yeah, he basically, like, he's just here to cause a problem. I'm actually surprised that the professor gave him a Peepo helmet, because, like, the whole point of the helmets was to make the monkeys easier to deal with, but I think they'd know that's not how Spectre works. Something that happened in that little intro scene is, they talked about how, putting the monkeys in virtual space makes them easier to watch over. And, before putting Spectre in, Spectre pops up and says, I'll be the one to watch over them because I'm the boss. And then they treat him like just another monkey and toss him in. And he doesn't appreciate that. Invisibility power-up is very fun. That's a good long time too. I'll try grabbing this time thing and see if that's what the second gold pants is. Oh yeah, these yellow monkeys cannot swim. So when they when they fall in this river, they just kind of float forever. Very fun. Still missing a bunch more apes. Sometimes you get that 3D arrow that tells you where some nearby pants are located. Spectre's beaming some pants down onto monkeys over here. Oh no! All my hard work! Oh boy, where's... Oh wait, here we go. Something in this castle. Also, there's always enough monkeys in a stage to wear every pair of pants that's present. So the implication is that Spectre took the pants off these monkeys and then put them in a capsule? because there's always enough apes to, you know, fill every pair of pants. This way. Scared to pass through the center here. There it is. Alright. Oh, that's a big golden box of pants. Get in that washer. Having to defend your pants line that you're carrying behind you is actually like a really fun mechanic. I like it a lot. Still got that second one. I'm not sure what that's for. There's no way to arrange your pants line. It's always just trailing behind you wherever you move. But every like 10 pairs or so, it turns into like a box, which makes it easier to manage. Uh-oh. So this is a quote-unquote boss stage. Versus the boy. Also, Spectre doesn't have ears in this game. He didn't in the first one, but he gains them in Ape Escape 2. And keeps them from there on out. This stage, Spectre's in a UFO, and he's making my life hell, because what he's doing is this. He's just doing this. He's just flying around with like 80 pants trailing behind him. So what I gotta do is I gotta drop these bomb discs nearby when he goes through, and set some of those pants free. Then this kind of distracts him for a bit. Back around the edge. Where is he? No, he's still in the middle. R1 in this lets you lock on to maybe just bosses, but I think it works on regular monkeys. But that makes this a little bit more doable. Oh! Leave this world! Oh, I'm about to die. Let's see. Come on. I need those. Spectre, please. Remember where the dang machine is. Oh no! Oh no! This is a disaster! Okay, so when you die, you respawn into like the same instance of the stage. So my pants pile is gonna be around here somewhere. There it is. Okay, doing the square mash thing also inhales all the pants that are surrounding you. That's good. I think he's just got his own personal stash left. Well, I'm still missing some. Spectre, where are you? Oh, we still got some. Go this way. Let's go through the water, so the apes can't go in there. And get an extra clean. Okay, here's the washer. Okay. This part's pretty good. He says something like, "So you got them all." Well, don't worry, Spike. The real battle begins here. He's taking it very, very seriously. Even though all he's doing is just, like, being kind of annoying. And the professor explains S-ranks. Which I probably did not do. Yeah, I got A. Then once you finish a route, it shows you the route you took, and the ranks that you got, and then, like, I guess that's the number of gold pants and S ranks that you've gotten in that world. Oh, and then there's, here's something really good. Here's a bunch of nude apes going into a hot spring. And this is your reward for doing well. So you get a certain number of monkeys. I have earned 15. And you've got yourself a little public bath here. And I get to add 15 apes to this stage. All these apes have predetermined behaviors and activities. And you can visit this anytime. And this is basically the ape book of this game. You can check out what each ape is thinking. They've all got a different little thought bubble and different little activities. So this is where, like, the usual Ape Escape flavor comes in. Now, something that's fun is that I can go back to the training room after this, which is the big circular room that had all the screens in it. And it looks like there's room for, like, 8 of these. So I think there's probably a unique one for each world, which is pretty good. So I checked this room out before the stream, got a little sneak peek, and some of the good ones that I remember are this guy that's running around. He's just yelling, big bath, over and over, and like slipping on his ass. These three dancing guys, this guy's going, get you, this guy's saying, let's do the saru get you dance together, that's the Japanese name of the game. And the guy on the right is like, how long are we going to dance for? Didn't see this guy out here drinking a cold milk last time. I don't feel like reading. Anyway, so that's what this is. It's very nice. So this is the hub. Save and load. This is the world select. This, I'm not sure what it's for. At some point, the professor says something about minigames, so since it's an Ape Escape, I assume that there are minigames, and they're probably in here. And then these are all the, like, scenes. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of these. And I think that's how many worlds there are, so 6 worlds, 6 fun little ape collections. And let's go see the game real quick. Go pay a visit to an extremely high-def PS2 memory card. Because this memory card is the only thing on the screen that is 3D, they kind of went out, like, all out on it, and just looks really good. Let's save over my the spoilers file. I'm doing better. I got 13% instead of 11. Let's get another good look at that. A good memory card. Okay, so let's hop back in there. Also, it's fun. I just like the little scene that's going on in the middle here with Natsumi or Natalie. I'm used to using the Japanese names now. Typing away as usual, Professor doing nothing as usual, and Spike looking ready to go, and then there's just like a bunch of pants and the washing machine. They're working double time out here. So this is the way you select worlds, or you select routes. So you start from this center disc platform thingy, and you choose where to jump to. You start from like a specific spot on that course. Haven't unlocked this one, but we have access to this like kind of desert area, and then this leads to both the water area and the grass area. I'm gonna go back here and see if it'll let me take a different route. I haven't gone back here yet. There's no flags up, so I'm assuming... Okay, no, they're still up. Okay. So the route thing is just, like, flavor, basically. It doesn't mean that you actually have to play, like, the first two to get to the fork. So... Yeah, okay, so this will be the next stage. We'll go ahead and do this. So this is a warning about Blue Pants Monkey. They can swim. That's their big thing. They're weak at running, though. So, if you can keep them away from the water, then you're in the clear. Sure, there's nothing super important in here. Thank goodness for highlighted words. So Spike cannot swim in this game. I can only assume that it's because it's got that vacuum. So if I fall in the water, I'm freaking dead. And from previous experience, what little I have, losing all your pants in the water is no fun. I'm specifically mean experience in this game, by the way. Just from life. But yeah, like, when you fall in the water, all the hardened pants that you had will just kind of, like, scatter around. These little frickers will scoop it right up. Oh yeah, something else to note. You can actually inhale the pants off a monkey pretty quickly. You'll need to, you know, do it for like a split second there. But if you do that, then they don't like fall on their ass and get kind of disabled, and they can easily retaliate. What's going on over here? Okay. Great. Oh, ball. Spectre's here. I didn't even notice him. Nope. Still missing two pants. Oh wait, I see you. I see him. Oh yeah, a really cute detail is that when you shoot these guys out over the water, they skip like a stone. I thought it was all of them. There's the final chance. Get far away so I can turn around and look. Boy, here they come. They're hungry. Still missing the final pants. It's gotta be over in this back area. They're probably hiding. Oh yeah, here he is. Alright. Whoa. I really like that Spectre is like a constant presence in this game. He's just always there, causing me trouble. And Mischief Boy. Oh, was there a target? I didn't notice it. But usually there's something that happens when you shoot a target. I think I saw one on another stage. Okay, well, we'll run back in and see if anything happens when I shoot a target. Also, there's like no information on this game, so I have no idea if there's a like a true ending situation for getting all ranks. All the gold pants and all the rank S's. Let's see, where was... Oh, I see the bullseye. Where are you? Oh, too far. Two pairs of pants here. Anyone want to come hassle me? Come on, buddy. Got what you need. Come here. You have to climb over the little platform. See if I can get this shot. Just 1-8. Nope. That wasn't very good. He didn't skip at all. Alright, let's see. That was also not even the right direction. I'm like super curious now. Alright, can I just like hit him again? Nope. Ah, got it. Okay, that just gave me like an extra life. So that's not too exciting. definitely not worth all that work. I don't think you can use the beach ball. Whenever it got close to the vacuum, it just kind of like bopped away. Was it a 3-up? Okay, I guess that's a little bit more worth it. If we ever need to farm live, I guess that's the place. Now, there's a button here. Okay. Okay, so I think that's gonna mess with the water level. Okay, it looks like the thing that points me towards pants is a power up. These mechadiscs. I didn't notice when I picked it up before, but... Oh, frick. Oh, no. I wish that you had to press a button back to do that, but unfortunately it just starts whenever you hop on there. Make all these guys really easy targets. They suck at walking. And also, there's just a bunch of capsules under here. Oh, the water's filling back up. Oh god, what? I've made something that they desire. Okay, so I guess the mecha disc with a heart on it makes a banana with the sexy lips on it, and the apes love it. So that's good to know. Pack these bad boys away. I didn't notice that these stages had names. This one is Monkey Resort Island. Oh, I've done this stage. Okay. This stage has boats. This is the one water stage that I peeked into. You can get here from the first stage of the desert area. Oh, I see. That's a pants compass. Naturally. Slipped on something. Perhaps banana. Come on down, everybody. Check out this. That's a hell of an 8 blast. Oh, there's a switch. Okay. Gotta lower this water level. Actually, this is not the stage that I thought I did. This is a different one. Out of here before the water rises again. here's a guy. Oh, he's just crawling on the ground. There's still a pretty hefty amount of pants left uncollected. Oh, I see. There's a... Oh, didn't step on that yet. There's stuff on the outside of the stage, too. Switches over here. And these are all submerged pants and capsules. Oh boy. Spotted me. There's a pants capsule. He's not pointing me to. Not sure. Oh, up here. Oh, this guy. He's just walking free. Lock that switch again. Head over to this side. Oh, there's an island over here. How do I... Oh, okay, I need to get on that boat that's on the outside. Way over here. Didn't actually need to lower the ball or water level. The water volume, sure. Oh. Ah. Okay. Whoa, this boat is like drifting. This is way more fast-paced than I expected. There's a switch so I can get back down from the island very easily. Is that it? Yes. Nice, polite bundle of pants. Alright, only B rank though. Yeah, the big box definitely feels big. Let's see. Let's go. Take all the pants from Spectre. Maybe what I'll do is translate these after the fact on the VOD, and then put those in like the YouTube subtitles. That would probably be good. Not very. Oh, what? It's underwater. It's good usually if you can get that to happen. Like, put the bomb close to Spectre himself. When you break the chain. Oh god, how do I get out though? I don't know where the final pants is. Too fast. See if we can find a pants compass somewhere in the stage. I didn't know I could climb this. Oh no! Compass in here? Didn't have the time. Maybe he has them now. Yes! Okay, there's the pants. Just gotta figure out where he stops. Oh boy. Alright. Nice, nice, nice. Spectre's taking this very seriously. Alright, did pretty well there. So I said I'd make this one short, so let's do one more route, and then we'll call it a night. Two more apes, I think, compared to last time. It's kind of fun that it makes you place each ape, even if you've already been to the scene before. Watch them all sprout. Give it a save. Hey, you showed up to Piposaru 2001. A Japanese-only in-between game between Ape Escape 1 and Ape Escape 2. It's a game about washing pants. I'm actually really glad that they got to do this weird in-between game between 1 and 2, and like just kind of try something dumb. Like, basically, their philosophy with the minigames, but applied to a full game. Yeah, it's basically Ape Escape Gaiden. Okay, so we'll start over here in Dirt World. And this has a whole new kind of ape. That's right, it's a Cactusaru. These guys will put up a cactus disguise, and while they're doing that, can't get them. I think that's basically it. And they have a deep blue pants, if I will. Or actually, no, they're just wearing a freaking cactus outfit. But they have blue pants on beneath it. thing. This is a very long explanation of the Cactusaru's abilities. So yeah, while they're a cactus, I don't think you can inhale them, but you can bop them with other ears. So they're not actually much different. They're actually easier to deal with, since they stand still on purpose. Oh. Oh yeah, there's another target here too, huh? I'll go ahead and hit it. This one's substantially easier. I'd say missing it. You know, I'm not even sure that being a cactus makes them immune to inhales. Yeah, this game is definitely has a Yoshi story thing going on. Something that's really fun is, alright boys. When you've got a ton of them sucked in like this, the noises that they make are really cute. Farewell. I'm honestly, like, super in love with this game. The length of the stages is perfect, because they're not too long, not too short. Just kind of get in there, do your thing, and get out. Okay, so it looks like this one lets me dip back into Water World, but then it'll come back to Dirt World. I'll go do this Water World one. This one extremely has boats. This has way more boats than the other one did. And then after this, we will have seen everything that I spoiled for myself by playing when no one was looking. Whoops! No! I'm gonna restart the stage. There's no point in turning in these pants early. Yeah, like, Ape Escape is something that has always been simultaneously appealing, but also unappealing? Like, I had no experience with it. I never saw anybody play it. It was always just something that kind of existed. And then, my most recent Ape Escape exposure before playing Apes 1 myself was PlayStation All-Stars, so that didn't make a good impression at all. Yeah, like, I rented the first game when I was a kid and did not have a DualShock controller, so I couldn't play it. And then I just kind of never went back. But now I'm here, and everything's good. Never felt so good in my life. Makes me very sad that you probably won't get another one of these games. It's been a while. I feel like the Ape Escape development environment is one where they need to be able to take a lot of... Ah, frick. They need to be able to take a lot of chances, like, with gameplay and stuff, and experiment. And I feel like, AAA game budgets don't really have room for that anymore. and Sony doesn't have a handheld, basically. So, like, the last thing they tried to make was Escape on the Move, which I imagine was probably like a smaller budget thing that they could get funding for. And boy, that didn't work for them. That game apparently was very bad. I'm not even sure if it was done by the same development team or not. But it was apparently critically panned, and so I think it's probably gone now. And there's no real hope of an Apes game appearing on another console because it's a first-party game. So, guess we'll see. Leave me alone, Apes. Whoop. Stand. Whoa, those pants are flying free. That's where I wanna be. Oh, that's the start of the stage. Ooh, capsule hound. Plenty of pants. Alright, two pants left. Yeah, I think this game would do very well as like a downloadable thing. I feel like maybe we're getting to the point where AAA can start doing more downloadable-only games. Like, with console developers, or console, with like Sony embracing indie games. Like, just try and make a game on an indie budget. It'd probably work, right? Just pretend you're not Sony. You can't spend all that money. Just make a PlayStation game. Make a modern PlayStation game. Maybe. That's all we need. Yeah, I feel like Ape Escape is definitely the most charming, like the closest thing that they have to even touching like the standard Nintendo charm. And it's freaking dead. It's freaking gone. Luckily, I never played any of them, so I get to experience all this now. As do a bunch of you. Yeah, that's a good point. HAL Laboratory has been doing some smaller scale projects. Box Boy and Box Boy. They did Harmonite. Let's see what this is all about in a second. Yeah, it's a Please Wait a Moment Ape. That's how you want to do it. A little message on the loading screen. Let's just see what this does. Let's drop it down. Alright. Big psychic burst. Farewell. I'm nervous to make that jump. Yeah, Ape Escape definitely doesn't, like, have a Sony feel to it. Like, Konami is a pretty good guess, if you had to guess who made it. A better spot to jump from. It's like... Just go in. I'm not entirely sure what that did. kind of felt like a second, like that it was maybe like a time stop bubble? I don't like, for tear away or the planet. It's definitely got, well, this is going to sound extremely disparaging, but it's got a kind of Funko Pop attempt at cute feel to it to me. It's not really what I'm looking for. Oh, we're going to go into Snow World for a little bit here. Or... is there another choice? Oh, I can head over here to Hell, I guess? Happy Halloween? So here we have undead apes. I'm gonna leave translation up to Bolt, because he's better at this than I am. So if you want to read this, get your read on. Get a screenshot of it real quick. So I'm gonna hit the X button. Alright, so he's Coffin Boy. I like the music here. These guys kind of like lurch toward you. Oh, they rise out of the ground in a coffin. I gotta, like, knock him out of the coffin, I guess? Yeah. I think that works. Yeah, they walk like zombies. It's very cute. I also like this, little drone that just carries a flashlight. These buttons do. Oh, I bet when I shine light on him, he'll pop out. Bombs are definitely the easiest way to deal with them. Oh no! Yeah, there's blinks. Still gotta go back and finish that at some point. I'm too in love with apes at this point now. Very distracted. The music here is really chill compared to what I was expecting. My most recent Halloween-themed game world that I visited was Gex 1. That's not a particularly good representation of the Halloween theme. Shockingly. Come back. It's nice of Spectre to keep giving me more apes to reveal these other apes. I feel the same way, Bolt, about Gex Enter the Gecko, also known as Gex 64, which I own every version of, for some reason. I have the English and Japanese copies for PlayStation and Gex 64. The Japanese version has really good box art, though, so I can justify that one. I found that one in the wild. I'm very proud of it. It took me almost a whole year of living in Japan. Poison water. It sounds like if you jump out quickly, you won't take damage. It kind of feels like bowling. Knocking these monkeys into the coffins. It's actually very fun. It seems like the same gimmick as the Piposaru, but like it actually works. Whoa, no! Ooh, close. Easier than the other stage. I don't know that I have the fortitude to watch the Extra Life thing, but I appreciate what it did. But that's a lot of Gex to watch with my eyes all at once. It's a whole lot. So I can either continue through Hell World or go back to Dirt World. I think I'll loop back into Dirt Zone. Yeah, Spectre just like constantly being there is really good. The only thing that I wish is that I wish that he got outfits for every world, like a nice funny Halloween costume and like a mountain boy, a water world boy. Plenty of possibilities. These are mines, I assume. Or maybe they're just spiky. Well, Spectre's probably gonna tell me. He warns you that you'll get hurt if you mess around with him, and then Natsumi says, like, doesn't that mean the monkeys will also get hurt, too? And then he's like, wait, you're right! I messed up! Yeah, these are just cactuses. Cacti, excuse me. Another one of these. Let's see what it does this time. Oh boy! What's happening? To me? Alright, fine. Yeah, having to read like 100% hiragana is not fun. It's a whole lot of figuring out where words start and end. Sentence particles are my best friend. In that case. This is the first stage that we've gone to that's had, like, balls, isn't it? Gotta be extra embarrassing for these, Well, see ya. Oh boy. Goodbye also. To me. But anyway. Oh, a t-shirt. Oh, I just realized how many pants are around the edge of the screen. Anyway, it's gotta be real embarrassing for these cactus boys, because they lose their pants, but they still got their, like, little cactus tops. And, like, cactus greaves and, frickin' bangles on. That's just not a good look. Still super not sure what that power up does. Also, I don't know if it's bugging anyone else, but the noise it plays when I pick up a little health piece sounds almost exactly like the menu noise from Sonic R. And I don't like it. Ah. Oh, those are mines, yeah. Confirmed. Washing machines over here, I can't remember that. Oh, I'm on fire. I'm on fire. Help! Is that metal hot? I think it's cool. To be fair, it's not exactly an iconic noise, but I have played a lot of Sonic R. Let's try this thing again. It looked like Spike pulled out the monkey radar for a second there. I'll try that again with no monkeys around. Nope. Nothing there. Oh boy, I'm on fire again. Still not really sure what that mechanic is either. I guess the metal gets hot in the sun. Grab this finger thing one more time. Oh, okay. Oh, I can mind control them. Alright. So you hold down the, is that pointing me towards pants? Don't I have them all? Oh, it's pointing towards the washing machine, okay. But yeah, so you hold down the button that you normally use to just quickly dispense your mega discs, and to aim it and throw it. Oh, you can do it with this thing, too! I had no idea! And then you can control all the apes in the blast. Yeah, there was definitely a washing machine that was in one of the oases. Oh, oasises? Oases. Alright, so this time we got Spectre. I think each of these Spectre stages has a name for, like, Spectre's plan for the stage. Or something about what Spectre's doing there. Because I'm pretty sure this stage is called Spectre's Declaration of Independence. He's very serious. Hey, this is gonna make this easier now that I know I can toss these. Oh yeah, for people just tuning in, this is what Spectre does in this game. Also, those pants just got swept up in the whirlwind! He gets very serious about, pretty much anything. And makes your life hard by just, like, trailing the pants around the stage in a big, long, fast roller coaster pattern. You gotta use bombs to break his chain. Oh boy! See ya! Oh, that actually works! That's so many pants! I wasn't prepared for that to actually, like, do something. But yeah, Spectre considers each of these boss levels to be a very serious showdown. And don't get me wrong, they are. He's holding deer to one single pair right now.
There they are.
Alright. I do not know where the washing machine is, however. Assuming over here, because I haven't been here yet. Sorry. Alright. Yeah, that's another thing. It does sound like a time is running low sound. Oh man, we perfected that first go. Also, I have 39 lives? That's good. I'm glad to hear this. Oh, we've gone back to the onsen. I wonder if it's always an onsen then. Oh, okay. It's a different style of onsen. So we'll place the apes that we've earned. This one seems a little bit less good than the first. This guy's having a bad time. He's the one getting his ass hurt over and over. Also, for people who didn't see the first one of these that I went to, this is basically the 8th book of the game. Since you don't catch individual monkeys, based on your performance on a specific route, you earn a number of monkeys that you get to place into a little onsen scene. And each one of them has, like, a thought bubble that you can look at. And they're all doing a little action. And it's very cute. I'll peek into the first world's hot spring as well. love the loading screen for this one too. They're all just running in. They're all very excited to get clean. Clean boys. There they are. Every time you go in here, you get to place them over and over. This is a much more idealized hot spring experience, or public bathhouse, rather. So yeah, I think that's gonna do it for Piposaru 2001 tonight. Thank everybody for coming. Thank everybody for coming. I don't think this game's gonna be quite as long as Apes 1, because as you can see, like, it's pretty straightforward. Nice, quick little stages. Nothing too confusing, no hours-long final stages, I'm sure. And then once we finish this, we'll move on to Apes 2. I gotta figure out which dub I want to play for that one. Because, hoo boy, I sampled the English dub, and I really love Apes 1's English dub, the US dub, I should say. Because it sounds like they just hired amateurs, or just had amateurs from the studio, like, just talk, basically. It's very charming. Spectre sounds like he's about to burst into tears at any moment. And then the British dub, there's a British dub, a specific British dub for the first game, which was super bad! Didn't like that one. But then the US dub for the second game, the main character is just Ash from Pokemon doing his Ash voice, and the main girl is Misty doing her Misty voice. And that's gonna be weird. That game also has a British dub, I think. And then there's a bunch of other, like, French, etc. But if I play it in another language, it's gonna mean lots of supplemental text is unreadable. So you might just have to deal with Ash and Misty. I'm unsure. But I'll make that decision when we get closer to the time. So yeah. That's gonna be it. It's just a little hour and a half Apes tonight. Cause I started way later than I meant to. So thanks for coming, and I will see you all next time. Sometime later this week, probably. Thank you!